Oh, hey there, Mia. How have you been? Still busy? Wow, that is great. So it sounds like the cookies have been a big hit. No, I get it. As an entrepreneur, you definitely want to maximize your revenue, and making sure you're selling your lemonade and cookies for the right price is important for doing that. You're right. Supply, demand, price. It can be a little overwhelming. Why don't you sit down for a minute? I bet you could use a little time to recharge. Yeah, we'll put our heads together and see if we can help you double-check your pricing. So, between selling lemonade and adding cookies to the menu, Mia's lemonade stand is doing really well, but she wants to make sure that she has her prices set correctly in order to maximize her profitability. Our job today is to help Mia determine what her ideal pricing should be and when to adjust it to meet market conditions. But before we get started, I wanted to talk about some differences in today's lesson. In most lessons, we cover material and ask a guiding question at the end of that section. Well, because today's lesson is a review of concepts that we've discussed in this unit, I'll ask the guiding question at the beginning of each section, give you some time to answer the question, and then go over the answer with you. This is a great way to see just how well you've understood some of the topics that we have discussed in this unit. If you end up thinking that answering a question was pretty easy and your answer is similar to what we discuss, it's probably because you have a good understanding of the material. But if your answer turns out to be wrong or you find that you really struggled to answer the question, you may need to go back and review previous lessons, including videos, games, and PDFs. Okay, now that we've gotten that out of the way, let's talk about today's guiding questions. By the end of the lesson, you should be able to answer the following. How can Mia use concepts around market equilibrium to analyze her pricing of lemonade? How can Mia use knowledge of the factors that impact demand to help predict demand for her lemonade on any given day? How can Mia use knowledge of market forces like demand, supply, and competition to help adjust pricing on her lemonade? You should also start thinking about how to answer our big picture question. Why is it important for entrepreneurs to understand market forces like demand, supply, and competition? Okay, let's get started with our first guiding question. How can Mia use concepts around market equilibrium to analyze her pricing of lemonade? You may want to consider market occurrences like shortages and surpluses. All right, pause the video while you answer the question. When you're finished, we can go over the answer to the question. If you remember, market equilibrium occurs at a price when the consumer demand for a good or service is the same as the quantity supplied by producers. It's that point where our supply and demand curves intersect. At that price, every consumer with demand for a good or service is able to purchase it, and producers are able to sell all of the units they supply to the market. But what happens when the price for a good or service is either too high or too low? Markets end up with either surpluses or shortages. For Mia, this means that if her price is set just right, most days will end with no leftover lemonade and with everyone who wanted a glass having been able to buy one. Now, if Mia is consistently selling out of lemonade with a line full of customers still waiting, there's a shortage of lemonade in the market, and she can afford to raise her prices. But if there is leftover lemonade most days, Mia has a surplus on her hands, and it might be time to lower her prices. And while price has an impact on demand for Mia's lemonade, there are other non-price factors that can shift demand in a market. How can Mia use knowledge of the factors that shift demand for her lemonade on any given day? Pause the video while you answer the question. Now, on any given day, Mia has an expectation about how much lemonade she thinks she'll sell. But things like income levels, changes in customer preferences, demographic changes, the price of related goods, and expectations about future prices can all impact demand for lemonade. What if there is a fair in town and all the neighborhood kids spend their money on rides and funnel cake? Well, that will probably decrease demand. But if the local ice cream shop suddenly raises their prices, demand for Mia's lemonade should increase as people look for a better value. What do you think would happen to demand for Mia's lemonade if several of the families living in the neighborhood all went on vacation at the same time? You're absolutely right. Demand would decrease due to a demographic change. Let's take a minute to think about our last guiding question. How can Mia use knowledge of market forces like demand, supply, and competition to help adjust pricing on her lemonade? Pause for a moment while you answer. First, Mia needs to consider how the competition in her market impacts her ability to set prices. Remember, the more competition in a market, the less power a producer has over price. Then, she needs to consider demand and supply in the market, finding that sweet spot in pricing where people are still willing to buy her lemonade, but she is still willing to sell it, is difficult. But it ensures that she reduces the amount of risk she is taking as an entrepreneur. And understanding how changes to demand and supply impact the market allows Mia to be proactive in setting the price of her lemonade in order to maximize profit. In today's PDF activity, we're going to take a look at the type of competitive market Mia is operating in and try to help her set the optimal price for her lemonade. In this unit, we have discussed how price and other factors impact consumers' willingness to buy a good or service and a producer's willingness to supply that good or service. We also talked about how accurate pricing can help create equilibrium in a market. But we also talked about how problems with pricing can lead to surpluses and shortages. And we looked at how different types of competition impact how producers act in a market. In our next unit, we're going to take a closer look at different issues that arise for business owners. But until then, remember to keep investing in yourself one lesson at a time. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.